going to hurt you one bit. Just relax and sleep. Sleep, sleep, sleep. And in the morning, you'll find yourselves in your new home. Eh, my pets?
Good morning, Doc. What you got there?
Howdy. I found some new friends. Listen.
Wasp, you better be careful. They can sting a man to death.
Don't worry. We understand each other. They know who their friend is. They can tell.
Yeah, but they know when you ain't, too.
Nonsense. If you knew about wasps what I know, you'd have no fear of them, my boy.
No fear.
Zinthrop,
huh? Zinthrop. it's about wasps.
I'm so glad you dropped in, Mr. Barker. Mr. Barker, I'm on the verge of a great discovery.
Discovery? What do you mean?
Well, sir, I almost perfected a new method of extracting royal jelly from the queen wasp.
According to my figures, you're better at extracting funds from the company. Now, look here, Zinthrop, over $1,000 last month for miscellaneous.
Yes, yes, I know. But, Mr. Barker, let me just show you something. Just let me show you something. Already, I've learned to slow the process of aging. Soon, I shall be able to reverse it entirely.
What are you getting at, Zinthrop?
Look, what do you see?
See a big dog and a little dog.
Let's say an old dog and a young dog.
All right. So what?
Well, they're exactly the same age. You see, the little one, Greta, has been given regular injections of my compound from the queen wasp.
Just like I told you, Mr. Barker.
Now, look here, Zinthrop. I understand about science and progress and all that, but you were retained to extract queen bee royal jelly. Now, it's a health food, a cosmetic. It's not a miracle drug or an elixir of youth. That sort of thing is impossible.
Oh, but Mr. Parker...
Zinthrop, I'm sorry, Zinthrop, but I'm going to have to let you go. You just don't seem to be one of the team. You understand. Good luck. I'm sure you'll fit in somewhere.
Fit in. Somewhere. Oh, no, don't worry, my friend. We shall find a home somehow. Somewhere. Oh, but you sound impatient. Your babies, huh? They're hungry and they must be fed. Now, how would you like a nice, juicy little caterpillar, huh? You'd like that, wouldn't you? There. Now, you must eat them. Be strong because, well, we have a lot of work to do together. Yes, sir.
See, gentlemen, sales for the last fiscal quarter have dropped 14.5%. There has not been a corresponding drop in our competitor sales. I trust one of you gentlemen has a satisfactory explanation for this decline. Not one little suggestion, gentlemen. We'll start with you, Thompson. As public relations manager, no doubt you have some faint glimmering of what's happening to stolen products. Well, Thompson?
Well, you see, I...
I had no idea you were such an excellent public speaker, Thompson.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Darlin. I guess I'm not feeling very well this morning.
I'm sorry you aren't.
I think I can tell you why stolen products are falling off so badly, Miss Darlin.
We're listening, May. Where would you put the responsibility for this decline?
On you, Miss Darlin.
I imagine you have arguments to support that contention.
We've all been looking at it for the past 20 minutes. The most convincing argument is right on that graph. May I show you? Thank you. Now, right here in April is when Starlin sales started falling off.
Very clever of you, Lane.
Would you mind waiting until I finish, Miss Darlin?
That's enough, Lane.
Relax, Willis. My apologies for the interruption. Go on.
Thank you. Now, as I said, sales began to fall in April. But the reason for the fall was back here in February. Now, the Starlin products have always been thought of as something of a modern miracle in the cosmetics trade. A firm built to a multi-million-dollar-a-year business on the strength and appeal of one person, Janice Starlin, from the beginning right through until February of this year, only one woman's face was used to advertise those products. Your face, Miss Starlin. The public has come to accept you as a symbol. Well, now, after 16 years, they see a different face. They don't trust it. They feel cheated. The simple fact is that Starlin Cosmetics should have Janice Starlin's picture advertising them. Well, that's about all I've got to say.
Darn good job of saying it, too.
I agree. Lady makes a lot of sense on that score, Miss Starlin.
I think I've had enough flattery for one morning, gentlemen. It's a very convincing argument, Lane.
There's
only one small factor you've overlooked. Not even Janice Starlin can remain a glamour girl forever.
Miss Starlin?
Yes, Mary.
There's a Mr. Zinthrop in reception. He says he has an appointment.
Been a very informative get together. I'll be off for now.
Hello, Arthur.
Yes, Miss Dollar.
I'd like to see you in my office, please.
Sure, Miss Dollar. Take it easy, hotshot. Something on your mind, Miss Dollar?
Some work on royal jelly, haven't you?
Oh, hello.
Is there any real therapeutic value in it?
Well, I'd say so. Of course, a lot depends on each individual's reaction to the stuff.
What do you mean?
Just that no two people reacted precisely the same way. One man's meat's another man's poison.
Oh. But you think royal jelly can be beneficial in some cases?
Queen Bee said a lot of stuff about it.
I'll accept that as an affirmative answer. Supposing a more powerful form of royal jelly could be obtained from the queen wasp, for example. I mean, well, do you suppose that might have some rejuvenating effect on a human being?
I'd stay away from wasps if I were you, Miss Dolan. Socially, the queen wasp is on level with a black widow spider. They're both carnivorous. They paralyze their victims and then take their time devouring them alive. They kill their mates in the same way, too. Strictly a one-sided romance.
Well, I'm not exactly interested in the love life of the Queen Wasp. I want your opinion on the possibilities of using enzyme extracts from royal wasp jelly commercially.
If you want an honest opinion, Miss Stone.
Of course I want an honest opinion.
And my advice is forget about it.
Thank you, Arthur.
Anytime, Miss Stone.
Have Mr. Zinthrop come in.
minutes, madame, you shall see a miracle you shall not believe. Oh, no tricks. You may look if you like. I have no tricks. Well, don't look at me. I'm not changing. I do not believe one animal, so I bring two. I show you again, yes?
Yes, I must be sure.
Yes, madam.
Short of a miracle. Two miracles. And you say that you'll accept my word that I won't cheat you.
You won't. I know you're a good woman, even if you do not like other people to know it. However, my formula may not be good for human beings. I have not tested yet.
You will on me.
Oh, no, 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 no. There might be danger.
Those are my terms, Mr. Sintra. Janice Starlin will be your next guinea pig.
Though it may take a little time to prepare sufficient extract, a week, maybe more.
I'll make whatever arrangements you may need for your equipment.
Thank you, madame. Now I see how you built all this.
I'm very close to losing it, Mr. Zinthrop. Maybe working together we can save Janice Darlin Enterprises. Maybe even make it bigger than ever before.
Yes. Oh, yes.
I'm sure the next 3 months we'll see a rise in Starlin sales that will surpass anything we've dared imagine. Mr. Zinthrop is working on the final stages of a development that will revolutionize the cosmetic industry. He's to have a free hand in his experiments and will be answerable to no one but myself. At the moment, I cannot divulge the nature of Mr. Zinthrop's experiments, but I can assure you it will bring worldwide recognition to Janice Darlin Enterprises.
Intuition, if you like. It's just that there's something about this whole business that doesn't smell right.
that laboratory, the secret experiments. Zinthrop himself. The only thing he's missing is a genie with a lamp.
You better leave the intuition to me. I'll let you buy me dinner.
Buy you dinner? What's happened to your sporting blood? I thought we were going to toss for the check.
Oh, no. You won the last 3 times.
All right, look, I'll make a deal with you. Dinner is on me if you promise to keep an eye on what goes on in there.
What do you want me to do? Read her mail and send you messages and keep her code?
You could do worse.
Oh, no, Mr. Cooper, not you, too.
I've been trying to tell Bright Eyes here that I think Zinthrop is a phony and a confidence man.
If I were sure of that, I wouldn't be worried. I think he's a lot more dangerous. A quack.
Oh, I don't follow you, Coop.
Well, a confidence man would just be interested in your money. The only damage they can do is to your pocketbook. A quack can be fatal.
So I says to him, I says, listen, Ivy, I'm getting sick of this TV every night. I mean, you know, we can do the same thing in a nightclub. Well, or both. Mm-hmm. Good morning. Janice Darling Enterprises. I got 2 words for you. Drop dead. Twice. Irving? Calls me to tell me Dr. Cyclops is on Channel 9 tonight. Christ, I've seen it twice already.
Good morning. Is Miss Darling in her office now?
Miss Darling's in conference. Would you like to speak to her secretary?
Oh, no, no, no. Just say to Miss Darling, I should like to see her when she has time, huh?
Yes. Was there something else, Mr. Zinthrop?
No, no, no. Goodbye.
What a character. A regular two-eyed Dr. Cyclops.
Even the bow.
Good morning. May I see Miss Zardling, please? He's a real weirdy. Wonder what his game is.
Who cares?
You know, Morton thinks he's a crackpot. I heard him telling Cooper so. Old Bug Eyes really has the execs worried.
About what?
That's just it. They don't know.
Oh. So anyway, back to Irving.
Thank you. obliged to order anything he requires.
It is no concern of yours, Gleason.
Make out a check for the full amount.
Sue? Mary. Can I talk to Mr. Latimer? Bill? Hey, listen. Gleason just got a bill for $2,300. Zinthrop. Enzyme extracts.
In the tissue.
Why is it taking so long? It's the third week.
You forget, my dear, there's more to you than a little kitten, no? Besides, there's a difference in metabolism.
Why not increase the dosage? Wouldn't that step up the process?
Patience, my dear, patience. We must tread lightly, with care, Your Honor.
phone is ringing.
Oh, yes, Miss Darlin. Good morning. Janice Darlin Enterprises.
Gentlemen, Janice Darlin Enterprises is about to start on the most widespread publicity campaign in the history of the cosmetic industry. Our slogan will be, Return to Youth for Janice Darlin. When Mr. Zinsrup arrives, there will be a press interview, and all questions regarding the rejuvenation process will be referred to him. That'll be all for now, gentlemen.
It's amazing.
Why, it's wonderful.
You look marvelous.
I said that will be all for now, gentlemen. Good morning. Oh, not you, Mary. Wait a moment, please.
Yes, Miss Darlin.
Isn't it wonderful? It's a miracle. A wonderful, incredible miracle.
We were so worried about you. We really thought you were in danger. We even went to plotting how to rescue you from Mr. Zinsrup.
It all seems so silly. It seems ridiculous. Oh, Mary. Mary, how old do I look? Tell me. How old do I look? Tell me.
Maybe 22?
That's how old I was when I started Janice Darlin Enterprises. Do you realize what that means? I'm back where I started, 18 years ago, with what it took 18 years to accomplish. It's like a dream.
Thank you.
Mrs. Enthrop.
Sure, he's our boy.
Is he?
natural emergency. Mm-hmm. Right. Well, it looks like we've got him. This is John Doe down at Central Emergency, auto accident. There's no identification on him, but he was wearing a lab smock and Phil Zinthrope's description.
Mary, get my coat and Lane, get a cab downstairs. He badly hurt.
Head injury, general contusion to the body.
He's had a severe injury and there's definite brain damage. Just how much, we can't tell as yet.
How long before you'll know?
It's hard to say, Miss Talley.
Who's the best man for this kind of injury?
Well, there are several top specialists.
Get the best. I'll take full responsibility for the expense.
Yes, Miss Darling.
I don't know, Arthur. I think it best we wait.
But it's been 3 days since the accident, Jan. And no sign of improvement. He's still in a coma. You heard what the doctor said. He may never regain consciousness. And even if he does, who knows how badly his brain has been damaged.
Well, I'll give it another 48 hours. If he doesn't regain consciousness by then, well, you can take over the laboratory, Arthur.
Janet.
It's my decision.
Touchy business, you know.
Max is right, Miss Starlin.
Don't have to second the motion.
going to bring the most fantastically saleable product ever developed by modern cosmetics to the public. And I don't intend to be restricted by timidity on the part of my own staff. Is that clear? Are you all right, Miss Darling?
Just a little headache, Mary.
I'm fine.
Can I get you something?
I'm all right.
I have some aspirin in my purse.
Sorry, Mary. Well, that'll be all for now, Jen. The main thing is to get you back to health. Take good care of him, Miss Warren.
Yes, Miss Darling.
Sure is funny about old Coop.
This is one day of work and you're ready to call missing person.
Well, he's a pretty conscientious guy, honey. If he felt sick or something, he'd have called in.
Relax. He'll probably be in bright and chipper in the
morning. Interrupting something?
Oh, we were just having a little coffee clutch, Miss Darling. We were talking about Mr. Cooper.
What about Mr. Cooper?
Well, about his missing the meeting this morning. Nobody's been able to reach him all day.
I wouldn't worry about that. Mr. Cooper's been here a long time.
Probably feels he's entitled to take a day for himself now and then. That's been trying to tell Mr. Lane.
Oh, by the way, Miss Starlin, how is Mr. Zinthrop?
Oh, fine. In a few days, we'll start the layout of the campaign.
Oh, I'm ready when you are, boss.
Look this over. Hey, Bill.
Huh?
Don't go getting any ideas about the boss.
Well, me? Don't be silly. I just wanted to know that I'm an eager member of the team. Still, she is looking a lot younger these days, isn't she? You think Zinthrop would give you any of those treatments? You know, break the watch or something?
You've got to help me. Something's happening. Something's happening to me. I can't control it.
There is something I must remember, but I can't.
Try to think. The wasp enzymes. The extracts you were experimenting with before the accident. Try to think.
Well, this is Zinthrop's notebook, Mary. No, from his experiments with Jan.
Well, how did Cooper get hold of it?
I don't know. If only Coop would show up. Mary, look.
It's Mr. Cooper's pipe.
Well, don't you get it? He's going to go out without his pants. I'll leave that pipe behind. He's still somewhere in the building. I bet a year's salary on it.
If he is,
he's dead. And the night watchman.
Only enough left for one more injection. One more. You've got to make more than. Help me,
Zinthrop. Please, please, my
hand. Zinthrop, help me!
Oh, what?
Help me!
Is he asleep?
I don't know.
Jinthrop.
Bill.
To be alarmed about, Mr. Sinthrop. I'm Bill Lane, and this is Miss Dennison, Miss Starlin's secretary.
Miss Starlin? The cat?
What about a cat?
Must warn her. Injections. Must not take any more injections.
Is Miss Starlin in danger?
Terrible danger. I was...
Take it easy, Mr. Sinthrop. You're still pretty weak. Mary, see if you can get Jan on the phone.
All right.
You, Mary.
Where are you?
We're in the building.
We're in Mr. Zintrop's room.
Something's happened.
Here, let me talk to her. Hello, Miss Starlin. This is Lane.
Why are you and Mary still in the building?
I myself.
Don't want to talk, Mary.
Mr. Cooper.